happen. You know, what is happening is a set of bullies with a very nasty ideology are pushing their way into everything in American life and now in British life. And what Meghan Markle said was so nasty and insinuating and destructive. She said somebody in the royal family said something about the possible skin colour of their baby. This could be a totally innocuous remark. Just like you say, you know, the father's ginger. I wonder whether the baby will be ginger. It's perfectly possible that somebody said something along those lines to Harry or Meghan at some point. She tells Oprah Winfrey that this is racism. No way is that racism. But she says it is. Now the royal family is racist. And so this claim, this way in which bullyish people in America who have very nasty agendas are trying to push their agenda into everything in American life, they've now done it at the heart of British life. They've now got the monarchy having to defend itself against totally unproved charges of racism. And basically, the royal family have got to do what everyone has to do in America and elsewhere. We've got to stand up to this. We've got to say, right. No, truth matters. Prove it. Show us that it's true. Don't just assert it. Don't just have millionaires moaning at billionaires on sets in great mansions saying, woe is me, because somebody in the family once said something I've decided is racist, and now I can rake in more millions about it. This is so, so wrong. And gotcha. Adults across America and Britain have to say, no, we're not playing that game, and right. We won't have you bully us.
Yeah, and keep in mind, Russia and China, our chief adversary, I would argue, in Iran. They're not going through this cancel culture. They plow through it. I don't want their system of government, but they actually know what the threat is out there. Piers Morgan was on with us a couple of days ago and said this, almost predicting what would have ultimately would happen. Listen.